Welcome back. I'm your teacher, Lisa.
Hi, I'm your teacher, Austin. Good to be back. Lisa, I just had my new credit card issued. Have you ever seen one with a picture ID on it?
No, I haven't. Let me see it.
Well, I didn't bring it with me today, but maybe I can show it to you later.
You really got it quickly. I thought you said you would get it next week.
I was in a hurry since I'll be going out of town. So I asked the credit card company to issue it more quickly, and they agreed to do it for a small service charge.
I see. I wonder what kind of questions our students are going to ask.
Why don't we check it out first?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's go. Help me help you.
Hello, my name is Corey.
My name is Melody. Help me, I do have a question. Can I exchange Taiwanese dollars at banks in the United States?
Thanks for the question. For the most part, you will be unable to exchange Taiwanese dollars at banks in the United States. I would advise exchanging your money in Taiwan or in the airport at some major airports in the United States. Although this is also not as frequent, so you will have to know in advance if you'll be able to exchange your money even at the airport in the United States. Stick with doing it at the airport in Taiwan.
Okay. 事实上，各位同这位同学，你问的这个问题很简单，在美国的一般银行是没有办法换到台币的哈，所以你最好就是在出国之前先换好美金，或者是在台湾的机场换好，或者是有一些那个比较大的国际机场哈，他们可能有可以换台币，但是这个都还是要先确定一下，免得你去了之后你没有办法有现金可以使用哈。那当然现在刚刚我们没有Austin 老师没有提，其实现在也有一些提款机哈，可以马上提，用你的信用卡提现金，提当地的 local 的那个币值来使用也是可以的。好的，我们看下一个题目。
Thank you for the answer. I would like to know that when signing an official personal document, should I sign my Chinese name or my English full name?
Thanks for the question. If you're signing an official personal document and you have doubts whether to use your Chinese name or your English name, I would say go with the name that's on your passport. And if you have both an English and a Chinese name on your passport, use both.
是的，如果你要签一份正式的文件，又特别是国际性的商场上的，我会建议你签你的跟你 passport 一样的名字。那 passport 一样的，比如说我叫徐丽仪，那我的我的拼音就是 HSULI 跟 I， 我就要签那种名字。那因为我又有英文名字在我的 passport， 我就会签 Lisa 丽仪徐哈 LIIHSU 哈，这是比较正式的。这样子的签法，你不要签只有中不能签中文，因为在国际上人家看不懂啊，不能签国字那种啊。非常好的问题，我们看下一位同学带来什么问题。
I have other question. What is the difference between name and signature?
Thanks for the question. There is a difference between name and signature.Your name is simply just that, your name. So it's printed out and it's very easy to read. A signature is a personalized mark or way of writing your name. Usually it's a little bit harder to read. Maybe it uses cursive. It might have some extra embellishments or maybe looks very fancy. But it's just a person's personalized mark. Keep in mind that often in the business world, you will end a correspondence or email with the name printed out. And then when it is printed, underneath they will add their signature.So there are two different things. And as a last thing to keep in mind, if you ask someone to sign their name, if it is an American person, most often they will think you mean to use your signature. So when you sign your name, you're not actually printing your name, but you are signing it with a signature. So just try to keep that in mind.
Okay, 谢谢 Austin 老师对我们这个题目的说明。Name 跟 signature 确实是不一样的。Name 就是你的名字。比如说我叫 Lisa 徐啊，这就是我的名字，但是我一签名的时候就是我有个人化的签名 啊，那这个签名呢，就是单单属于我自己的哈，而且我可能会加上一些别人很难模仿哈。还有一个就是当北美的人说 sign your name 哈，签你的名字，这个时候不是指 print 就是写那个印刷体哈 ，LISA 哈这种名字，而是这种签名的方式哈。那还有一个就是有时候在你的email 或者是你的书信里头，你除了打上你的名字之外，你还要签名。因为签名就等同于盖你的印章，那台湾也越来越多都用签名来代替印章，因为发现签名反而是更应该是更有更可信的，信用度更高。谢谢老师的说明，我们看下一个题目。
Thank you for the answer. I have a question that I think most people will want to know. Can I withdraw cash?From an ATM which belongs to a different bank than the one that issued my ATM card?
Thanks for the question. You usually can withdraw cash from an ATM that belongs to a different bank from the one from which your card was issued. But just keep in mind that if you are withdrawing money from an ATM from a different bank, you will almost always be issued a small service charge. Not very much money, but there will be a small service charge.
Okay.谢谢老师的回答，也谢谢这位同学你的问题。通常在别家银行他的提款机是可以领得到钱，但是在国外跟台湾一样，就是说他们可能也有通储这种系统，但是还是会付一些手续费就让你知道哈。OK。好，我们谢谢各位同学的提问，这都是非常好的，当你出国的时候可能都会碰到的问题。我们进入到我们今天的课程单元。
Last week we learned language used when making payments. For example, asking about price and confirming the price with phrases such as, I'm not sure that's right, and that doesn't seem to add up. We also learned appropriate responses of a clerk to a customer.
这是上一星期我们学的重点。就是谈到当你付款的时候会用的话哈，比如说别人付款，你觉得好像收的额度不是很像你所想的，你就可以说 I'm not sure that's right， 或者是 that doesn't seem to add up。还有一个就是你如果是一个收银员，你要跟顾客的互动，这是上一周 money talks 的重点。那我们今天来看今天学习的重点是什么？
Today we are going to continue learning language that relates to money issues. Our lesson today will concern banking. Let's check it out, our chapter focus first, and then we'll talk more about it later. So today our chapter focus has two parts. The first is to learn the language used by a bank teller. The second is to learn the language used by a customer at a bank.
好的，今天我们的课程重点是学习银行行员的用语，叫 bank teller， 他们会用的用语。还有一个就是学习在银行作为跟客户对话的一个用话。Okay, I think it's time to learn the key words and phrases. Pay attention to Austin's English explanations, and I will give you Chinese translations.And these keywords and phrases will be used in our conversations. Yeah, let's learn today's keywords and phrases. The first one is withdraw, 提款.
Withdraw, to take money from a bank account.
把钱从银行的账户领出来.
For example, I'm going on vacation, so I need to withdraw some money from my bank account.
I'm going on vacation, so I need to withdraw some money from my bank account. 因为我准备要去旅行，所以我需要从银行账户里一些钱出来。下个生字叫 accessible, 可取得的。
Accessible, easy for anyone to obtain and use.
容易让人家拥有或得到的。
For example, money is accessible by using an ATM card.
Money is accessible by using an ATM card. 利用提款卡，金钱很容易可以取得。下一个生字是 endorse. Endorse, 背书。
Endorse, to write your name on the back of a check or official document to make it legal.
在支票或是重要的文件上签名，让它在法律上有效。
For example, you forgot to endorse the check. I can't cash it for you if you don't.
You forgot to endorse the check. I can't cash it for you if you don't. 你忘了在支票后边背书，如果你没有签名，我就不能兑现给你。下一个生字是 denomination， 面额。
Denomination, the value of a particular coin or banknote.
指特定的金钱或票据上的金额。
For example, would you like the bills in large or small denominations?
Would you like the bills in large or small denominations? 你的账单想以大金额开出还是小金额的呢？ Sound, 动词，听起来，觉得。
Sound, to seem interesting, exciting, or something else according to what you have heard, read, or know.
指根据所听到、读到或知道的事情，感觉似乎很有趣、很兴奋。Sounds good, sounds great. 听起来很不错。
Sounds good, sounds great. Used for telling someone that their idea or suggestion seems like a good one.
用来告诉他人他们的想法或是建议听起来很不错。
For example, two people are talking. The first might say, "How does steak sound for dinner?"
Not so good. I had it yesterday. 好，那个晚餐我们就来吃牛排，你觉得如何？不太好因为我昨天才吃过哈。好，下一个生字是 issue， 发行，动词。
Issue。To give something to people officially.
发出正式的给他人事物。
For example, I'll issue the check after I know the amount.
I'll issue the check after I know the amount. 我知道金额后我会把支票开出来。Balance, 余额。
Balance, the amount of money you have in your bank account.
这是指在银行账户中剩下的钱。
For example, to check the balance in your account, please enter your PIN number.
为了要查询你的存款余额，要请你输入密码。Passbook, 存款簿。
Passbook, a small book showing the amounts of money that you put into and take out of your account, sometimes called a bank book.
好，这个是指一本小册子。记载着你提款和存款的金额，有时也称为存折。
For example, if you'll give me your passbook, I'll bring your account up to date.
如果你给我你的存折，我会定时告诉你你的账户的资讯。
Austin, we're going to show our students the conversation. Could you please explain the scenarios?
Sure, I'd be glad to.In the first skit, a bank teller is helping a customer. In the second skit, a customer is talking to bank tellers.
待会的两个会话呢，是一位银行行员正在帮助一位客户处理事情。第二个会话呢，是一位客户跟一个银行行员正在讲话。All right, here we go. Conversation 1 and 2.
Can I help the next person?How may I help you today?
I'd like to cash this check. Is there any service charge on this?
Sir, do you have an account at our bank?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
We do not cash non-customer checks drawn on other banks. I'm sorry.
Could I open an account first and then deposit it into my account?
Yes, sir, but you will need to wait 3 to 5 days while the check is processed before the funds are accessible.
That's not a problem.
Okay, please fill out this form.And give me 2 picture IDs.
Would a driver's license and a credit card work?
That would be fine. Also, please endorse the back of the check.
Is there any service charge for this?
No, sir.
Here you are.
Here is your account number. Please sign this. Anything else today?
No, thank you. I think that's it.
Have a nice day. How can we help you today?
I want to buy some traveler's checks. Do I need to line up?
You can go to the office on your left and talk to our manager, Mr. McDonald.
Thanks. That's good. I'm in a bit of a hurry.
What can I do for you today?
I need some traveler's checks.
What is the total value of those checks, and what denominations would you like them in?
I need $5,000 in hundreds and fifties.
Sure. How does 40 $100 checks and 20 $50 checks sound to you?
I think that should work. Is there a service charge on that?
No, but when you cash the checks, there's a small service fee of about 0.05%.
Okay, please issue them.
Here you are. Please sign your name here on each check.
Okay.
Here's your receipt. Please remember to keep this in a separate place for safety purposes. Is there anything else I can do for you?
I'd like to check the balance on my savings account.
Do you bring your passbook with you? I'll access your information here so that you don't have to go back out and line up again.
I appreciate your help.
Welcome, students, to Language in Focus. 我们针对刚刚 conversation 1 and 2 有一些很值得再谈的哈，老师跟 Austin 会带来一些的互动哈。Austin, I know English, you know, uses abbreviations a lot, such as a rep for representative. What about ID? Stands for what? And when do we need to provide a picture ID?
ID stands for identification. We will be requested to provide a picture ID in many situations, such as opening bank accounts, applying for a mortgage, renting a car, buying alcohol or cigarettes, applying for a job, and many other things.
好的，你们同学都知道，英文常常有很长的字，他们就喜欢用缩写哈，像刚刚我说的 rep, representative, 哈，业务代表 sales rep。那我就问他 ID 也是一个缩写是哪一个字呢是 identification 是你的身份的证明那我又问Austin 老师什么时候你需要 picture ID 他说很多情况下我们会被要求带着照片上的这个身份的证明譬如你要开立银行的账户你要申请抵押贷款租一辆车买烟买酒或者申请工作 ID 的意思就是身份证明 identification 哈 ID 哈有 picture ID 有大头照的证件对我们来说就是双证件那就是身份证跟健保卡
For example, in order to cash this check, we need two forms of picture ID.
In order to cash this check, we need two forms of picture ID.为了要兑现这张支票，我们需要你两张有照片的身份证明文件。Austin, is it common the company or shop charge us a service charge?
It depends. If they do, it should be explained in the term or policy. If they don't, they should also give you a notice, free of service charge. Service charge means that cost of something will be increased.Usually because of extra services, such as delivery or repair.
Service charge, 服务费。他说，我说要不要收呢？他说这要看情况。如果他们要收服务费，他们肯定会在条款中、政策中解释。如果他们不说，他们也会给你一个通知，叫做 free of service charge, 免收服务费。那服务费是指东西成本将因为额外的服务在总金额之外还会外加上去的一笔钱作为支付的服务的费用比如送货啦或者是修理等等
For example, there is a slight service charge for delivery.
There is a slight service charge for delivery. 我们会收取一点运送的服务费 好的。Austin, there are many things we should do for safety purposes. What about particularly a banking scenario?
Yeah, right. While traveling abroad, there are many little details we should pay attention to in order to be safe. Take banking as an example. You should always keep your passbook and ATM card in different places. Not to mention, never write your password in the back of an ATM card or passbook.
For safety purposes, 就是为了安全起见。他说对的，出国旅行哈，很多小细节都要注意，以便安全，保持安全。以银行的情况为例，你应该始终保持你的存折跟提款卡在不同的地方，更不用说你不应该在 ATM card 上边或存折的背面上面写出你的密码。Okay.
For example, never put a credit card and its PIN number in the same location for safety purposes.
Never put a credit card and its PIN number in the same location for safety purposes. 为了安全起见，千万不要把信用卡和密码放在同一个地方。好，这以上是 Language in Focus。我们现在来看 situations。在银行时，你会碰上的对话情况可以依着你的角色的扮演来归类。比如说，你是银行的行员或者是客户。作为一个银行的行员时，你会提供服务。那作为一位顾客呢，你就要告知对方关于你自己的需求为何。
So our first set of situations deals with being a bank teller. So first, offering help as a bank teller. Can I help the next person?
Can I help the next person?
Next person in line, please.
Next person in line, please.
How may I help you today?
How may I help you today?
Then we have giving explanation as a bank teller. Do you have an account at this bank?
Do you have an account at this bank?
We do not cash a foreign check.
We do not cash a foreign check.
We do not cash a non-customer check drawn from other banks.
We do not cash a non-customer's check drawn from other banks.
And then we have asking more as a bank teller. So, please sign the back.
Please sign the back.
Please endorse the back.
Please endorse the back.
Next, we have situations as a customer. First, telling what you like as a customer. I want to buy some traveler's checks.
I want to buy some traveler's check.
I'd like to cash this check.
I'd like to cash this check.
I'd like to check the balance in my savings account.
I'd like to check the balance in my savings account.
Then we have different ways to ask for help as a customer. I want to deposit this check into my checking account.
I want to deposit this check into my checking account.
I want to withdraw some money from my savings account.
I want to withdraw some money from my savings account.
Is there any service fee on this?
Is there any service fee on this? 同学，刚刚我们在做对话练习的时候，有很多可能同学会觉得不是很熟悉的情况。为什么呢？因为我们台湾的同学们很少开支票。如果你不是一个大老板，你大概不会开支票。但是在国外，在美国，写支票是稀松平常的事，他们几乎所有的东西都用支票的方式，所以这是一个老师想要补充的。还有一个就是cash 这个字，你会发现我们都把它当作动词，说比如说 I like to cash this check， 意思就是说这张支票我要把它兑现成现金。然后我们也说到我要 check the balance， 这个 balance 就是我的余额是多少。这个通常还分了 checking account 跟 saving account。 各位同学， again， 这是什么意思呢？ checking account 就是我们的活存， saving account 就是我们的定存。那通常定存他们也会分时间的，希望你不要在这个时间上一直去提领，那么你的利率就会比较高。那通常一般都是 checking account， 意思就是活存，你可以随时提领。还有一个就是有两个生字各位同学一定要记住的，叫做 deposit， deposit 就是存款。 哈。另外一个相反的就是 withdraw 哈，we call withdraw 哈，那动词的部分哈，你看哈，有人就会用提领哈这两个生字。还有一个同学问我说 ，ATM 到底是怎么来的 ？Auto teller machine， 那个 teller 就是那个银行柜台前的那个小姐，就叫做 bank teller。好的，同学，希望刚刚老师的几个说明，可能是因为文化上的不一样，所以可能这个 banking 的这些生字对你来说是新的。那现在我们来听来看啊 ，conversation one and two。
Can I help the next person? How may I help you today?
I'd like to cash this check. Is there any service charge on this?
Sir, do you have an account at our bank?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
We do not cash non-customer checks drawn on other banks. I'm sorry.
Could I open an account first and then deposit it into my account?
Yes, sir, but you will need to wait 3 to 5 days while the check is processed before the funds are accessible.
That's not a problem.
Okay, please fill out this form and give me 2 picture IDs.
Would a driver's license and a credit card work?
That would be fine. Also, please endorse the back of the check.
Is there any service charge for this?
No, sir.
Here you are.
Here is your account number.Please sign this. Anything else today?
No, thank you. I think that's it.
Have a nice day. How can we help you today?
I want to buy some traveler's checks. Do I need to line up?
You can go to the office on your left and talk to our manager, Mr. McDonald.
Thanks. That's good. I'm in a bit of a hurry.
What can I do for you today?
I need some traveler's checks.
What is the total value of those checks, and what denominations would you like them in?
I need $5,000 in hundreds and fifties.
Sure. How does 40 $100 checks and 20 $50 checks sound to you?
I think that should work. Is there a service charge on that?
No, but when you cash the checks, there's a small service fee of about...0.05%.
Okay, please issue them.
Here you are. Please sign your name here on each check.
Okay.
Here's your receipt. Please remember to keep this in a separate place for safety purposes.Is there anything else I can do for you?
I'd like to check the balance on my savings account.
Do you bring your passbook with you? I'll access your information here so that you don't have to go back out and line up again.
I appreciate your help.
Well, time is up. We hope today's lesson has provided you with some ideas of how to deal with things when you go to a bank.
In today's lesson,We learned appropriate and useful language used at a bank from the perspective of a bank teller and a customer. For example, the bank teller may ask the customer questions like, Do you have an account at this bank? The customer will be asking for services, saying things such as, I'd like to cash this check, and I'd like to transfer some money from my savings account to my checking account.
Okay.刚刚Austin 老师 review 了，不管你是 bank teller 或是 customer， 这些用词都非常的重要。We have one more lesson for you to learn this semester. It's going to be very practical and helpful for you if you are overseas someday. Hope you'll be back on time next week. When you go to work today, hope you'll have a wonderful day. Have a nice day.
Thanks for tuning in.
Bye-bye.